సో అవర్ నెక్స్ట్ టాపిక్ ఈజ్ టార్క్. వి కంప్లీటెడ్ మూమెంట్ ఆఫ్ ఇనర్షియాను. సో నెక్స్ట్ వీఆర్ స్టడీంగ్ అబౌట్ టార్క్. క్లియర్? సో సీమ, ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్, దిస్ ఈజ్ ఎ బాడీ ఆఫ్ మాస్ ఎమ్. ఐ అప్లై ఫోర్స్ ఇన్ దిస్ డైరెక్షన్, దెన్ వాట్ దిస్ ఫోర్స్ విల్ డూ? దిస్ ఫోర్స్ విల్ ప్రొడ్యూస్ యాక్సిలరేషన్. ఎఫ్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్స్ టు ఎమ్, ఏ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్స్ టు F by M. So this force produces acceleration. What kind of acceleration is this?
Linear
acceleration. So here A is called linear acceleration. Are you able to understand? Similarly, come on. So if this is a disc which is rotating around this axis, are you able to understand? Disc is rotating around this axis with a particular angular velocity omega, or let us call it as omega 1. Okay? So to this disc, if I apply force in this direction, so here also we are applying force, here also we are applying some force. Now can you say what this force will do in this condition? From omega 1, the angular speed increases from omega 1 to omega 2 here. Okay, and what is omega 2 minus omega 1 divided by time? It is alpha, no? Angular acceleration. Are you able to understand, ma? So this kind of force is producing linear acceleration. This kind of force is producing angular acceleration. Okay, so the force which produces linear acceleration, we call it as just force only, linear force. But here, the force which is applied at a particular angle, so at a particular direction, it is applied at a distance of r, no? So this product of r into f, this we call it as torque acting on a body. Or we can call it as the effect of rotation produced in the body is also called as torque. So here, torque not only depends on applied force, no? It also depends upon the distance where you are applying the force also. So this total product we call it as torque acting on a body. Are you able to understand? So force produces linear acceleration, torque produces angular acceleration. That is the meaning of this one. Okay, ma? So make a note of this one and write down. So here we can write force produces linear acceleration, whereas torque produces angular acceleration. Clear? So this is what we call it as torque. Okay? So in this condition, where this is the radius vector where we are applying this force, and this is the force is applied at an angle of 90 degrees to the radius vector. So here torque, I can write torque is equals to R into F. This is one formula for torque. So they are perpendicular, no? So directly I am writing R into F. Are you able to understand, ma? Okay. Now let us try to understand this torque in one more method. For example, this is a pendulum of mass M. Clear, ma? And I will apply force in this direction. Okay? So this is a pendulum of mass M. I am applying force in this direction. Now this force, can it produce any angular acceleration or this one or not? No. Then what is the effect of this force? No, only tension will increase with the help of this force, but effect of rotation cannot be produced. Okay? So if I want to make this bob to move in a circular path, what I have to do? I have to apply force. Instead of this force, I have to apply force in this direction. Are you able to understand, ma? So which force is responsible for making the body to move in a circular path? The component of force which is perpendicular to the direction of radius vector. So that force is responsible for producing tangential, or you can call it as angular acceleration of this body. Are you able to understand, ma? ఓన్లీ దిస్ ఫోర్స్ ఈజ్ రెస్పాన్సిబుల్ టు మేక్ దిస్ బాడీ మూవ్ ఇన్ ఏ సర్క్యులర్ పాత్. ఓకే, ఆర్ ఇఫ్ ఐ డ్రా ఏ డయాగ్రామ్ లైక్ దిస్, ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ దిస్ ఈజ్ ఎ పెండులమ్ ఆఫ్ అగైన్ మాస్యం. నౌ ఐఎమ్ అప్లయింగ్ ఫోర్స్ ఇన్ దిస్ డైరెక్షన్ అట్ ఎన్ యాంగిల్ ఆఫ్ థీటా టు ద హారిజాంటల్. ఆర్ ఏబుల్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్, క్లియర్? సో వెన్ ఐ హ్యావ్ అప్లైడ్ ఫోర్స్ ఇన్ దిస్ డైరెక్షన్, దిస్ ఫోర్స్ ఈజ్ నాట్ రెస్పాన్సిబుల్ ఫర్ ప్రొడ్యూసింగ్ ఎనీ రొటేషన్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ బాడీ. క్లియర్ అమ్మా? వెన్ ఐ హ్యావ్ అప్లైడ్ ఫోర్స్ ఇన్ దిస్ డైరెక్షన్, దిస్ ఫోర్స్ ఈజ్ రెస్పాన్సిబుల్ ఫర్ ప్రొవైడింగ్ రొటేషన్ ఇన్ ఎ బాడీ. క్లియర్? నౌ వాట్ ఐఎమ్ డూయింగ్ ఈజ్ ఐఎమ్ అప్లయింగ్ ఫోర్స్ అట్ అన్ యాంగిల్ ఆఫ్ థీటా టు ద హారిజాంట్. దెన్ కెన్ ఐ సే దిస్ ఫోర్స్ ఈజ్ రెస్పాన్సిబుల్ ఫర్ రొటేషన్ ఆర్ నాట్? కెన్ ఐ సే ఈజ్ దిస్ ఫోర్స్ రెస్పాన్సిబుల్ ఫర్ రొటేషన్? ఓన్లీ దిస్ ఫోర్స్ ఈజ్ రెస్పాన్సిబుల్. నో కాంపొనెంట్స్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు స్ప్లిట్. ఆర్ ఏబుల్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ మా? సో దేర్ ఫోర్ దిస్ ఫోర్స్ ఐ కెన్ ఆల్వేస్ స్ప్లిట్ ఇన్ టు టూ కాంపొనెంట్స్. నో సో ఇఫ్ దిస్ ఈజ్ థీటా అండ్ దిస్ ఈజ్ ఎఫ్, దిస్ ఈజ్ ఎఫ్ కాస్ థీటా అండ్ దిస్ ఈజ్ ఎఫ్ సైన్ థీటా. ఆర్ ఏబుల్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ మా? సో ఇన్ దిస్ కండిషన్ విచ్ ఫోర్స్ ఈజ్ రెస్పాన్సిబుల్ ఫర్ ప్రొడ్యూసింగ్ యాంగులర్ యాక్సిలరేషన్ ఆర్ రొటేషన్ ఇన్ ద బాడీ? ఎఫ్ కాస్ థీటా ఈజ్ రెస్పాన్సిబుల్. ఓకే, వై వీ ఆర్ టేకింగ్ కాస్ థీటా హియర్? బికాస్ వీ వాంట్ దట్ ఫోర్స్ విచ్ ఈస్ పర్పెండిక్యులర్ టు ద రేడియస్ వెక్టర్. ఆర్ ఏబుల్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్? రేడియస్ ఆల్సో వీ కెన్ స్ప్లిట్. క్లియర్? సో దిస్ ఈజ్ ద రేడియస్ వెక్టర్ అండ్ టు దిస్ రేడియస్ వెక్టర్ వీ షుడ్ టేక్ ద పర్పెండిక్యులర్ ఫోర్స్. దెన్ దట్ కాంపొనెంట్ ఆఫ్ ఫోర్స్ ఈజ్ రెస్పాన్సిబుల్ ఫర్ ప్రొడ్యూసింగ్ యాక్సిలరేషన్ ఇన్ ఎ బాడీ. విచ్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ యాక్సిలరేషన్? యాంగులర్ యాక్సిలరేషన్. క్లియర్ మా? మేక్ ఎ నోట్ అప్ టు హియర్. పాయింట్ హియర్ వీ కెన్ రైట్ డౌన్, రైట్ డౌన్. సో ఫర్ రొటేషన్ టు బి ప్రొడ్యూస్డ్ దేర్ మస్ట్ బి ఎ కాంపొనెంట్ పర్పెండిక్యులర్ టు ద డైరెక్షన్ ఆఫ్ రేడియస్ వెక్టర్. పర్పెండిక్యులర్ టు ద డైరెక్షన్ ఆఫ్ రేడియస్ వెక్టర్. ఓకేమా? సో ఇఫ్ యు ఆర్ అప్లయింగ్ ఫోర్స్ ఇన్ దిస్ డైరెక్షన్ ఆర్ ఇన్ దిస్ డైరెక్షన్, దీస్ ఫోర్సెస్ ఆర్ నాట్ రెస్పాన్సిబుల్ ఫర్ రొటేషన్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ బాడీ. ఓకే, ఓకే. నౌ లెట్ అస్ స్టడీ మ్యాగ్నిట్యూడ్ అండ్ డైరెక్షన్ ఆఫ్ టార్క్. మ్యాగ్నిట్యూడ్ అండ్ డైరెక్షన్ ఆఫ్ టార్క్. క్లియర్మా? సో ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ దిస్ ఈజ్ ఎ బాడీ ఆఫ్ మాస్యం విచ్ ఈస్ రొటేటింగ్ అరౌండ్ దిస్ యాక్సిస్ విత్ అన్ యాంగులర్ వెలాసిటీ ఆఫ్ ఒమేగా. ఆర్ ఏబుల్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ మా? సో ఆన్ దిస్ బాడీ ఐఎమ్ అప్లయింగ్ ఎ ఫోర్స్ ఆఫ్ ఎఫ్ హియర్ అండ్ దిస్ ఈజ్ ద రేడియస్ వెక్టర్. క్లియర్ మా? సో హియర్ ఫోర్స్ ఈజ్ నాట్ ఇన్ ద ప్లేన్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ బోర్డ్. హౌ ఫోర్స్ ఈజ్ ప్రెజెంట్? ఫోర్స్ ఈజ్ పర్పెండిక్యులర్ అండ్ ఇన్సైడ్ దిస్ బోర్డ్. ఆర్ ఏబుల్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ మా? సో ఇఫ్ దిస్ ఈజ్ మై యాక్సిస్ ఆఫ్ రొటేషన్, ఇఫ్ ఐ అప్లై ఫోర్స్ ఇన్ దిస్ డైరెక్షన్ దెన్ బాడీ కెనాట్ కంప్లీట్ ఎ సర్క్యులర్ పాత్. ఆర్ ఏబుల్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ హౌ ఫోర్స్ ఈజ్ హియర్? ఫోర్స్ ఈజ్ లైక్ దిస్, పర్పెండిక్యులర్ అండ్ ఇన్సైడ్ దిస్ బోర్డ్. ఓకే, సో హియర్ హౌ కెన్ ఐ రైట్ ఎ టార్క్ ఈక్వేషన్? టార్క్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్స్ టు ఆర్ ఇన్ టు ఎఫ్, బికాస్ ఆర్ అండ్ ఎఫ్ ఆర్ దే ఆర్ ఎగ్జాక్ట్లీ పర్పెండిక్యులర్ టు ఈచ్ అదర్. క్లియర్? ఓకే. Now what I do is, on the same body, at the same distance, now I am applying force in this direction. This is my applied force. Now what can I do? Split this one into two components. That's all, no? How can I split this force into two components? So this is the force in which I can split into two components, no? So what is the angle theta between R and F in this condition, can you see? First let us calculate angle between this radius vector and force. Okay ma? In this condition, what is the angle between radius vector and force? Where we have to take the angle? Where should we take the angle? Can I say? Can I say this is the angle between R and F? No, that was the rule we studied in vectors, no? Angle between the vectors should be taken only between two tails only. Then two tails are not present here, then what can I do? Displace this vector. A vector can be displaced anywhere, no? But its magnitude and direction should not change. So same R dash vector I can displace here also. Now two tails are created, no? So now this becomes the angle theta between R dash and F dash. Are you able to understand, ma? So now this force I can split into two components. So one is F cos theta, another one is F sin theta. So out of these two forces, again, which force is responsible for producing rotation? F sin theta, because it is again perpendicular to the radius vector. Are you able to understand? So here torque equation, how can I write? Here I can write torque is equals to F sin theta into R. Or I can write torque is equals to F R sin theta. Are you able to understand, ma? So if there is angle theta between force and radius vector, then you have to take sin theta. Torque is equals to F into R into sin theta. So here also you can write F into R into sin theta, no? Because here theta value is how much? 90 degrees, sin 90 value is 1. Like that also we can study. Clear, ma? Okay. Now what I will do is, same relation I can write like this also, no? R sin theta into F. Can I write like this also? Okay. It means what I am trying to do now? What I am trying to do? I am trying to split this radius vector into two components. Clear? How can I split that one into two components? Let us see. Clear, ma? So, this is the body which is rotating at a distance of R dash, and this is my applied force. Clear, ma? So, this applied force, I can extend it backwards, no? Or this is my force which I can draw like this. Clear? So then where is the angle theta between them? This is the angle theta between R dash and F dash, no? If this is angle theta, what is this angle? 180 minus theta, no? What type of angles they are? Vertically opposite angles only, no? So if this is theta, definitely this angle also will be theta. Okay, now this radius vector, I can again split it into two components, no, like this. Clear, no, ma? So this is R dash. Then if this is theta, what is this angle? This angle is 90 degrees. What is this angle? So theta 90, this angle should be 90 minus theta. That's all, no, ma? Then this side will be how much? R cos 90 minus theta. And this side is R sin 90 minus theta. R cos 90 minus theta is how much? R sin theta. This value is R cos theta. Are you able to understand? Now if you observe here, so again this radius vector and force, are they perpendicular? Are you able to understand, ma? This component of radius vector is how much? R sin theta. And this is the force, no? And what is the angle between them? 90 degrees. So again, can't I consider these two values? So definitely again I can write torque equation is equals to, you take this component which is equals to R sin theta, and you take this force which is F. So this is also one more method of writing the equation of torque. Are you able to understand, ma? So either force you can split into two components, or radius vector also you can split into two components. Whatever it may be, what we are trying to do? We are trying to take those two components which are perpendicular to each other, because only perpendicular force can produce rotation in a body. Are you able to understand? Make a note up to here. So, torque direction is given by, write down, direction of torque is given by right hand rule for cross product. or just you can call it as right hand thumb rule also. Clear? Right hand rule for cross product. So let us see how we can use this one. Sima, so this is the radius vector r dash, this is the applied force F. Clear ma? So what is the vector form of torque equation? Torque is equals to r dash cross F dash. This is the vector form. Why we have written this like this? Because torque is equals to Rf sin theta noma. Okay, this is of which form? This is of the form of A dash cross B dash is equals to AB sin theta. This is exactly of this form, no? Okay, so therefore we are writing torque is equals to R dash cross F dash. Clear? Radius vector is a vector quantity. Applied force vector quantity. Then torque is also a vector quantity and it must have a direction also because it is a vector quantity. Clear ma? So do you remember right hand rule for cross product? How we have to use our right hand? Place the right hand on first vector. Which is the first vector out of these two? R dash. So place here. Clear ma? Then rotate your hand towards the second vector. Second vector is F dash in this direction, no? So you place right hand here, apply, you rotate your fingers in this direction. Then what is the direction of thumb? Thumb is perpendicular and out of this board, no? That is the direction of torque. Okay? So torque direction will be always perpendicular to both these vectors. These two vectors are present in the plane of the board, no? But torque direction is in which direction? Torque direction is perpendicular and outside to the plane of this board. Clear ma? For example, this is radius vector and I am applying force in this direction. Clear? Then what is the direction of torque here? Like this, no? So R dash cross F dash. That's all, no? Here what is the direction of thumb? So it is perpendicular and inside the board. So that is the direction of torque. Are you able to understand? Or just in many of the problems it is just represented by the orientation of rotation direction also. So here if I apply force in this direction, body will rotate in this direction, no? This is what type of rotation? Anti-clockwise rotation. So here if I apply force in this direction, body will rotate in this direction, no? So this is what kind of rotation? Clockwise rotation. Okay? So just in terms of rotation also you can represent this direction. But torque direction is always perpendicular to both these vectors, radius vector as well as force also. Okay? If these two are present in one plane, then torque will be exactly perpendicular to the plane in which these two forces are present. Clear? Make a note of this one. First of all, write these two. So here, what is the note point we can write? Torque is perpendicular to the plane containing which vectors? Radius vector and force vector. So torque will be always perpendicular to the plane containing these two vectors. Okay? So right up to here. Completed number? Now let us try to understand what is the importance of this torque equation. So torque is written as R dash cross F dash noma. Clear? Or in scalars you can write torque is equals to Rf sin theta. You can write like this. Okay? Now let us take one practical situation here. So this is the axis of rotation around which a wooden door is present. Wow, good diagram. Clear? So this is the axis around which this door can rotate. Doors will be present, no? Understand? So on this door, where I have to apply force and in which direction, so that with minimum force I should be able to rotate this door. That is my question. Are you able to understand the question, ma? So where I have to apply force, such that with minimum force, I should be able to rotate this door. Shall I apply very near to the axis of rotation? Or shall I apply at the middle point? Or shall I apply at the end of this door? Definitely at the end of this door. Here if I apply force, then I will be able to rotate this one very easily with the help of minimum force. What is the reason? That's all. So torque is the product of R into F into sine theta, no? So sine theta is maximum if theta value is 90 degrees. So definitely what kind of force I have to apply? Perpendicular force to the plane of this door. Understand ma? And if this is the axis of rotation, this becomes my radius vector, no? So if radius vector is maximum, then torque also will be maximum. Are you able to understand? So this you should have observed in practical life also. At the starting of the door, if you try to push this door, this is very tough to open this one. Same force you apply at the end of this door, very easily you can move this door. Are you able to understand? Similarly, you should have observed when tire of a lorry or tire of a car gets punctured. To open the nuts of this tire, we use a very long rod, no? Understand, no? For example, if this is the tire, nuts will be present here, no? Nut will be like this. Clear? So we place a long rod on this one, which will be having a very long handle. Okay? So here the person will start jumping on this one. Have you observed this one? For bus, when you are going in a bus, when the tire gets punctured, this is the scene which you see. So there is a very long rod. Person will be standing here, he will jump on this one. What is the reason? If he jumps here, what will happen? Nothing will happen. If he jumps at a very long distance, then from the axis of rotation, R value increases, no? And weight of the person is a constant. Clear, ma? So if R value increases, what increases? The effect of rotation will increase. Very easily we can open this nut here. Are you able to understand? So this is the importance of torque equation. Clear? Make a note. So here, this is the x-axis and this is the y-axis which we are taking. So on the x-axis at a distance of point P, from here I am releasing one body. Clear ma? So this body will have a weight of mg, no? So this is a freely falling body. Then what is the torque acting on this body after a time interval of t? This is my question. After a time of t, what is the torque acting on this body? How can I calculate? First of all, who is applying torque here?
Mg.
Mg means? Gravitational force is applying torque on this body. To apply torque, there must be some force, no? Who is applying force here? Gravitational force is applying the force in this condition. Are you able to understand, ma? And about which point I want to calculate rotation? About this origin or around this origin, I want to calculate the effect of rotation of this body due to gravitational force, and that too after a time of t. So after a time of t, what will happen?
No, nothing,
nothing will happen, because torque, what is meant by torque? Torque is equals to Rf sine theta, no ma? Understand? So what is R value here? P. From this axis, perpendicular distance is P here. And what is the force acting? Again, the perpendicular force is mg. So these two values, they will never change, no? So torque is equals to R value is P. And what is force here? Mg. And can you say what is the direction of torque in this condition? Perpendicular and inside the board. Why it is perpendicular and inside the board? Because we have to use R dash cross F dash, no? So this is my R dash, this is my F dash. Then what is the direction of thumb? It is perpendicular and inside the board. So toe dash can be written as P into mg in which direction? Minus k cap. Can I write like this? So if this is x, if this is y, and if this is z axis is positive, I can take plus k cap. Where plus k cap is perpendicular and inside this board. Are you able to understand, ma? Or Let us try to do the same concept in some another method. Okay? So for example, after a time of t, this body has reached up to here. Understand? In a time of t, body has traveled this much distance and it is present here. Again, force acting on this one is mg itself, no? Are you able to understand? So if I draw this radius vector, so let it be r dash. This is r dash only, no? Now this is my radius vector, this is the force which is acting. Clear, ma? Now can you say what is the angle between this r and mg? How? Where I have to take theta? Just extend this r dash like this. I can extend a vector like this, no? So this becomes my angle theta, because angle should be always taken between two tails only. Clear, ma? So if this is theta, can I call this one also as theta? If this is theta, this is also theta, no? Understand? So this r dash, again I can split into two components, no? Understand, ma? Which component I have to take? So this is r naught cos theta, this is r naught sin theta. So again you apply the torque equation. So r sin theta into mg, I can take like this, no? Always I have to take which radius vector? The radius vector which is always perpendicular to the force direction. Are you able to understand? So this is the radius vector which is perpendicular to this one, no? So take r naught sin theta into mg. That's all, Dhamma. What is r naught sin theta? R naught sin theta is nothing but p, no? R naught sin theta is nothing but p. The again I substitute, so torque is equals to p into mg. Like this also I can solve. Again I got the same relation, no? Are able to understand, ma? So this is how we can do this body. Or if I want to do in one more method, I can write torque is equals to r naught into mg into sin theta. Clear, ma? Now can you say what is sin theta? Sin theta is nothing but opposite by adjacent, no? Opposite by hypotenuse. Clear? So torque can be written as r naught into mg into sin theta. What is opposite side to this one? Opposite side is nothing but p divided by hypotenuse is r. So again r and r gets cancelled, no? So torque is equals to p into mg. This method also I can do. Clear? So whatever may be the method of calculation, always you should get the same equation for torque. Okay, ma? In short, how you can remember? In short, how we can remember? So we are concerned about that axis and that force which are mutually perpendicular to each other. That's all. Clear? So just take this P and this mg, that should be my torque equation around this point of origin. Clear? Whatever may be the point, torque always is constant in this condition. Clear, ma? So P is a constant, no? M is a constant, no? G is a constant, no? Torque is a constant. Whatever may be the time, torque is always constant in this condition. So next topic is equilibrium. What is meant by equilibrium? Equilibrium means net force is zero. Then what will be zero? Net acceleration will be zero, or we can call it as linear acceleration will be zero. This is what happens when net force is zero. So there is one more type of equilibrium also, no? What is that one? Net torque is also zero. Understand, ma? If net torque is zero, then which angle acceleration is zero? Angular acceleration is also zero. Are able to understand? So when these two conditions are satisfied, then I will say the body is in equilibrium. Okay? So in linear motion also, body should be in equilibrium. And in the case of angular acceleration, in rotational motion also, it should be in equilibrium. Are able to understand? For example, if a body is traveling with uniform speed or uniform velocity, can I say it is in translational equilibrium? Are you able to understand my question? So a body of mass m, it is traveling with a velocity of v. Can I say it is in translational equilibrium or not? But it is moving, no? No. Are you able to understand my question, ma? Is it in translational equilibrium or not? But it is moving. No acceleration. It is moving with uniform velocity, no? It means what is zero? Acceleration is zero in this condition. Linear acceleration is zero. If linear acceleration is zero, already we have studied F net is equals to mass into acceleration, no ma? If this value is zero, this value also must be zero. So therefore, if body is either in rest position or if it is traveling with uniform velocity, definitely I can say body is in translational equilibrium. Are you able to understand? Because net force acting on this body is zero. Clear? Okay. Similarly, I will take this disc. Clear, ma? So this is a disc which is rotating around this axis with an angular velocity of omega. So is it in rotational equilibrium or not? But it is moving, no? So rotational equilibrium means what? What should be zero? Torque acting on this body should be zero. If a torque acting is zero, then angular acceleration will be zero. Angular velocity will be existing. Are you able to understand? So this disc is rotating with uniform angular velocity. It means for in 1 second it is covering 30 degrees, second also it is covering 30 degrees, third second also it is covering 30 degrees. So same angle in same time, which is called angular velocity. But angular acceleration in this condition is zero. So definitely I can say the body is in rotational equilibrium. So this is a translational equilibrium. This is called as rotational equilibrium. Are you able to understand, ma? Okay. Now, for example, if I take this body or if I take this rod of mass m and whose length let it be, whatever it may be the length is equals to L here. So here I am applying some force, here I am applying some force of F2 and here also I am applying some force of F3. Then can you say what is the effect of all these forces? What can be the effect of... Only rotation, huh?
Linear or the rotation?
If forces are applied like this, what will happen to the motion of this body? But I never said that these forces are equal. No? These forces may be equal, may not be equal. So there are two chances here. Body may be in translatory motion or body may be in rotational motion, our body may be in translational as well as rotational motion also. Three conditions are possible. Are you able to understand? So it depends upon the magnitude of these forces and also it depends upon the points where we are applying the forces. Are you able to understand, ma? For example, if I take this rod, clear? So at the end of this rod, I am applying 10 Newton. Here also I am applying 10 Newton. Now what will happen? This body will undergo translational motion, no? Body will move in a straight line. Understand? With a particular linear acceleration. Are you able to understand, ma? Because net force acting on this rod is 10 plus 10, 20 Newton. Okay? Now if I remove this force and apply force here, now what will happen? Are you able to understand? See, this force I am applying here, then what is going to happen? Now I can say the body is in translational equilibrium. Body will not move in a straight line, no? So it is in which type of equilibrium? Translational equilibrium. But it is not in which type of equilibrium? It is not in rotational equilibrium because continuously angular velocity of this body will increase. So here I can say angular acceleration is not equal to zero. So this is not present in rotational equilibrium. But it is present in which type of equilibrium? translational equilibrium. Why it is present in translational equilibrium? Because net force acting on this body is zero. Net force is zero, no? So this is one force, 10 Newton. This is another force, minus 10 Newton. If I take this positive, this I must take negative, no? So plus minus 10, zero. So therefore, definitely net force acting on this body is zero. But net torque acting on this body is not zero. Because how you calculate torque here? For example, this is my axis of rotation. Clear, ma? So this is my radius vector R1 or R. This is another radius vector R2. Or let it be, both are equal, no? Or let it be R1 dash, let it be R2 dash. Let it be F1 dash, let it be R. This is F2 dash. Are you able to understand, ma? So this is force F1, this is my radius vector. This is force F2 and this is my radius vector. Clear? So because of these two forces, can you say what is the direction of torque with the help of this force and what is the direction of torque with the help of this force? Can you say? So this is R dash cross F dash, no? Force is in which direction? Force is in downwards direction. This force I can displace here also, no? Are you able to understand, ma? So this is R dash cross F dash. What is the direction of torque? This is the direction of torque. That's all, no? Here which is the direction of torque? So here also, this same force I can draw here, no? This force I can draw here. Again, what is the direction of torque? Same direction. So are torques getting cancelled here? No. If torque is not getting cancelled, if it means that there is some net torque acting on this body. So definitely body is not present in rotational equilibrium. But it is present in translational equilibrium. So are you able to understand the difference, ma? So you have to calculate the net amount of torque. If net torque acting on this body is zero, then what can I say? Definitely it is in rotational equilibrium. Otherwise it is not. Have you understood? Make a note up to here. Sima here. So this is a rod whose total length is equals to 1 meter. Clear? So at a distance of 10 centimeter, I am applying a force of 20 Newton. And from here again at a distance of 20 centimeter, I am applying 30 Newton force. Clear, ma? So definitely the system will be in both translational as well as in rotational equilibrium, no? Because net force is not zero. Net torque also it is not equal to zero. So two types of motion will be there. But this rod will be in translational motion as well as rotational motion also. Clear? Now where I have to apply the net force on this rod so that both the both motions should be come into equilibrium. That is, translationally also it should come into equilibrium. Rotationally also the rod should come into equilibrium. Then where I have to apply the net force? That is my question. Clear? Think about this one. Sima, here, what is the question he is asking basically? So what is the point of application of net force for total rod should come into rotational equilibrium as well as translational equilibrium? That's all, no, ma? So it will come into translational equilibrium if I apply net force exactly in opposite direction, no? So here what is the net force? This is one force which is 20 Newton, another force is 30 Newton. What is the net force in this condition? One force is upwards, another force is downwards, no, ma? So here net force will be equal to 30 minus 20 is equals to 10 Newton is my net force. So if I can apply 10 Newtons, the body will come into which type of equilibrium? Translational equilibrium. Because net force acting on the body is zero. Are you able to understand? But to come into rotational equilibrium, net torque also should become zero, no? Are you able to understand? If net force is zero, body will come into which type of equilibrium? Translational equilibrium. But to come into rotational equilibrium, net torque also should become zero. Okay? So first of all, with the help of these two forces, let us calculate what is the net torque acting on this body. Are you able to understand, ma? So about which point shall I calculate? I will calculate about point A, so let it be point A, let it be point B, let it be point C, let it be point D. About any point you can calculate the net torque. Are you able to understand? So I will calculate torque about point A. Clear ma? So torque about point A. Okay. So how many forces are there here? Two forces are there, no? So two torques will be produced, no? So let tau1 be the torque due to this 20 Newton force. Understand ma? Now this is my point, no? It means I am considering that my axis of rotation is here. Are you able to understand? My axis of rotation is at point A. This is my consideration. Okay? So about this axis, what is tau1? Torque produced by 20 Newton force is how much? Torque formula. Rf sin theta, no? Here theta value is 90 degrees. So what is the radius from this axis to this point? 10 centimeter, 10. And what is the force applied? 20. So 200 Newton centimeter is the torque due to first force. That's all. Next, what is tau2? Torque due to second force. This is 30 Newton force, no? At what distance? 30. So 30 into 30. 30 into 30, just magnitudes I am writing. 30 into 30 is equals to 900 Newton centimeter. Okay? But these torques, they are vector quantities also, no? They will have direction also. So due to this force, what is the direction of torque? R dash cross F dash. This right hand rule you should not forget. So R dash cross F dash. This is the direction of torque, no? Perpendicular and out of the board. Due to this force, R dash cross F dash. Perpendicular and inside the board. So both the torques are in opposite direction, no? Then what is the net torque? Net torque is equals to 900 minus 200 is equals to 700 Newton centimeter. This is the net torque. That's all, Dama. So, and in which direction? What is the net torque direction? So, this torque is in which direction, Ma? This torque is perpendicular and inside board, no? So, net torque also is perpendicular and inside the board. So, therefore, here I can write 700 Newton centimeter is perpendicular and inside the board. That's all, Nama. Now, to bring the body into rotational equilibrium, I have to apply the same torque exactly in opposite direction. That's all, no? So, from the axis, so if I can write, I am applying force at a distance of x. And what is the net force here? 30 minus 20, 10 Newton is the net force, no? So x into net force is 10. This should be again equal to 700 Newton centimeter, no? That's all, Amma. What is this x value? The point where I am applying the force. Understand? From which point? Again from point A, because that is my point of consideration, no? And what is this 10? Net force, what is the net force in this condition? 10 Newton. So again, this torque should be equal to the original torque which is acting, but it should be in opposite direction. Are you able to understand? So what is my x value? 700 divided by 10 is equals to 70 centimeters. This is my answer. Okay, ma? So where I have to apply 10 Newton force at a distance of 70 centimeter, then this total rod will come into rotational equilibrium also. Are you able to understand? And this 10 Newton I have to apply in which direction? So here what is the torque direction? 700 Newton centimeters is perpendicular and inside the board, no? Now I have to apply this 10 Newton such that torque is perpendicular and outside the board. Then how torque is perpendicular and outside the board? So if I rotate my hand like this, then this is the torque direction, no? It means force I have to apply in which direction? Force I have to apply in this direction, and this is the 10 Newton force in which I have to apply. Or let us draw another diagram of this one. I can draw here only. So this is 10 Newton force. And what is this distance, ma? This distance should be how much? 70 centimeter. That is my answer. Are you able to understand? So torque directions are also very important, and the point which you are taking as your reference, that should be constant throughout the problem. Okay, now solve the same problem by taking another reference and you check whether you get the same answer or not. Clear ma? Now you take your reference as point B, this point. Are you able to understand? You take your reference as point B and now you check whether you get the same answer at same distance or not. Clear? Come on. Meeru A point. So two boys of masses 20 kg and 30 kg, so they should balance a fulcrum. Fulcrum means what ma? A balancing rod. Clear? Which is pivoted exactly at the center. And what is the length of this rod? 10 meters. So this length is 10 meters. Clear ma? So 10 kg boy, one boy is sitting here, one boy is sitting on the other side of this fulcrum. So they should balance this fulcrum. Are you able to understand ma? But what is the condition is given? One boy should sit at one end of the fulcrum. Then what is the position of the second boy? So that this balancing rod is in rotational equilibrium. That is the question. Are you able to understand? Here there is one condition, no? One boy should sit at the edge of the fulcrum. Okay? How can I do? Can you try? Try. That's all. For rotational equilibrium to become, that is for body to be in rotational equilibrium, net torque should be zero. So find out those positions where net torque will become zero. Clear? So time is not there. I will solve this one. See. So let us consider first of all, 30 kg body or 30 kg boy is sitting at edge of the fulcrum. So this is my case number one. Clear ma? So what is the first case I am taking? 30 kg boy is sitting here. Are you able to understand? Then what is the torque produced by this body at this edge of the, at this center of the fulcrum? So total length of the fulcrum is how much? 10 meters, no? Then this distance will be how much? 5. This distance also will be 5 meters. So toe 1 will be how much? Force into displacement. Force is 30 into 10. Weight of this body 30 into 10 only, no? And what distance from the center? 5. So toe 1 is equals to how much? 1500 newton meter. So this is the torque produced by first person. Are you able to understand? Then if second person is sitting somewhere here at a distance of x, then torque produced by this one and torque produced by this body boy, both should be equal, but in opposite direction. They are opposite direction only, no? So one torque is in this direction, one torque is in opposite direction. Clear ma? So therefore toe 2, how can I write? What is its weight? 20 into 10, no? 200. And from the center let he be at a distance of x, then this torque and this torque should be equal, then this rod will be in equilibrium. That's all, Rama. So equate both of them. So 1500 is equals to 200 into x. So x is equals to 1500 divided by 200. So 7.5 meters. What is meant by 7.5 meters? So see, this distance maximum is 5 meters only, no? So 7.5 means he will sit somewhere here, which is not possible. So case number one is not possible. Are you able to understand ma? So if 30 kg boy sits at the edge of the fulcrum, then other boy cannot balance this one. Then what is my case number two? Case number two is, so if this is the fulcrum, here which boy should sit? 20 kg boy should sit. Now I can balance the fulcrum. Clear ma? So how can I write torque equations again? So 20 into, what is this distance? 5. So 20 into 10 into 5. And what is the weight of a second person? 30 into 10. And he will sit at a distance of x. Let he be sitting here. Clear ma? So therefore, 0, 0, 0, 0 gets cancelled. So x is equals to 10 by 3. 10 by 3 is how much? 3.33 meters. This is my answer. This is satisfied, no? This length is 5 meter. So he should sit at a distance of 3.33 from this axis of rotation. Okay? So this condition is satisfied. Okay? So one boy is producing torque in one direction. Another boy is producing torque in opposite direction, and both the torques are equal and in opposite. So total torque will become zero and this fulcrum will be balanced. Have you understood? That's all. Okay. Rep inkon interesting questions chadamu.